Let us take the second question. A solid shaft in a rolling mill transmits 20 kilowatts at 2 hertz. Determine the diameter of the shaft. If shear stress is not to exceed 40 megapascal and angle of twist is limited to 6 degree in a length of 3 meter, full stop, take capital G is equal to 83 GPa, that is modulus of rigidity. Now the question which we have in front of us, we will write the data for this first. Here it is given that a solid shaft in a rolling mill transmits 20 kilowatts. So power is given. It is in kilowatts. We are converting it into watts by multiplying it by 1000. At 2 hertz, this 2 hertz is nothing but the speed. Here it is 2 hertz means it is in 2 revolutions per second. So this we can convert it into revolutions per minute by multiplying it with 60. So therefore I have RPM as 120. Next, determine the diameter of the shaft. This is the question. Here we have to calculate the diameter. If shear stress is not to exceed 40 megapascal, Fs is 40 megapascal, that is 40 newton per mm square, and angle of twist is limited to 6 degree theta, 6 degree. So I'll convert it into radian by multiplying it by pi and dividing it by 180. In a length of 3 meter, the length of the shaft is 3 meter, so it is 3000 mm. Take capital G, that is modulus of rigidity, as 83 GPa means 83 into 10 raised to 3 newton per millimeter square. So here I have to calculate the diameter, and this is the question which we have. As we can see here, Fs is also there and modulus of rigidity. So we would be using strength criteria as well as rigidity criteria. But before that, since power and speed are known, let us try to get torque first. So we'll start with the solution. Since power transmitted by shaft is given by P is equal to 2 pi nt by 60. Therefore, T is equal to P into 60 divided by 2 pi n. Power is given in the question. It is 20 into 10 raised to 3 watts divided by 2 pi into n. N is 120 RPM. Therefore, I will be getting the answer of torque as 1.59 into 10 raised to 3 newton meter. Now I have to convert it into newton mm, so multiplying it by 1000, so this becomes 1.59 into 10 raised to 6 newton mm. This is the value of torque which we are getting. Now let us write first the strength criteria. Based on strength criteria, the formula is T by J is equal to Fs by R. Therefore, T, it is 1.59 into 10 raised to 6. J is pi by 32 D raised to 4 for a solid shaft. Fs, it is given 40 radius is diameter by 2. So from left hand side and right hand side, D gets cancelled. So here I have D cube. This becomes 16. So therefore, D cube will be equal to 1.59 into 10 raised to 6 divided by pi by 16 into 40. So here if I calculate numerator upon denominator and then take the cube root, I will be getting the answer of diameter as 58.74 mm. This becomes equation number 1. So based on strength criteria, my diameter is 58.74 mm for solid shaft. Now based on rigidity criteria, the formula is T by J is equal to G theta by L. Therefore, T, it is 1.59 into 10 raised to 6. J is pi by 32, D raised to 4. Modulus of rigidity is given in the question. It is 83 into 10 raised to 3. Theta is 6 pi by 180 divided by, the length of the shaft is 3000 mm. So from this, if I calculate, if I shift D raised to 4 onto right hand side and this term in the denominator, here I would be getting first D raised to 4 as 5.60 into 10 raised to 6. Now if I want to calculate the diameter of shaft, I will have to take the square root twice. So if I take square root twice of this number, I would be getting my diameter of solid shaft as 48.64 mm. This becomes my second equation. Now if I compare from equation number 1 and equation number 2, in equation 1 the diameter is 58.74, in equation 2 it is 48.64. So I can say that we will be selecting the greater diameter, hence 58.74 mm will be the answer for us. That is, we are having a solid shaft and its diameter will be equal to 58.74 mm. And with this, we complete the question.